seem to have had the same idea.
Well, I don't know about you, but it's warm out there.
Yes, I noticed that when I was dancing with Luke. You know, I really got to congratulate you, Bobby. You and Scorpio did one job in that dance contest.
It wasn't very difficult, considering the fact that it was mixed.
Yes, I heard Scorpio make that accusation.
Bobby, I cannot tell you how difficult it was for me to dance badly, because once I hear that music, I just want to dance my little heart out.
Alex, somehow I have the feeling you have spent almost your entire life dancing your little heart out.
And what is that supposed to mean?
Oh, nothing special. It wasn't a dig. When I give you a dig, you will know it.
Well, it's nice to know where a girl stands, love. Excuse me.
Alex.
Yes.
Where you stand is that you are Luke's employer. Where I stand is that I love him very much, and I don't want him to have the kind of trouble he went through last summer.
You really put it on the line, don't you?
I figured it was about time I did.
You come on rather strong for a little sister, don't you think?
I love my brother. We've been very close since we were kids.
So he told me.
What else has he told you, Alex?
Oh, that he wants to get ahead in the world.
That's true.
And that he doesn't care exactly how he does it.
Wrong, lady. He cares very much how he does it.
Really? Now, I wonder, how could I have misjudged him? I just get the feeling that he wants to make a great deal of money and get all the very nice things in life.
Does he think you're going to help him do that?
Exactly.
Wait a minute. Is that why he's off running your little errands? Like tonight, for instance?
That's right.
Alex, please. Did he have enough time to do what he has to do before Scorpio took off after him?
You know, it still amazes me how we pulled it off as long as we did. I mean, I thought that once Luke and I were eliminated, that Scorpio would know, you know, right off the bat, it was just a big put-on. I've got to hand it to you, Bobby. You pulled it off beautifully.
Why is it that I don't understand exactly what it is I pulled off?
Well, he just needed a little time to check out a warehouse that I asked him to look at.
He knew Scorpio when he was gone.
That's right.
How come?
How come what?
How come it would matter to Robert Scorpio what the book is doing?
Oh, mad! I don't understand them. I will never understand them. You know, they never cease to amaze me. I mean, for example, like, Luke and Scorpio are very macho. They like to compete. Did you ever notice that?
I've noticed that. They like to compete over Laura.
Well, it doesn't necessarily have to be. Laura can be any woman, any man, any job. I mean, these are men, my darling. They are competitors.
Oh, I see. Like the olden days in Rome when they threw one another off of chariots.
Well, you might say that.
Alex, I know there's something I am not being told.
Bobby, what are you talking about?
Is Luke in any danger?
Life is full of danger.
Alex, I want an answer to that because I care about that man.
So do I.
No, you care about Alex.
Yes, I do. But I also care about Luke, and on a personal level.
How personal?
Not as personal as I would like. Not yet.
Oh, well, that's honest.
Bobby, you know I'd never do anything to hurt Luke. I think you know that.
What I know is that I'm going to have to accept that because I think that's probably the best answer I will get from you.
You're a smart girl, Bobby. And it is nice to know where we all stand.
Vacation or something. Hello.
I'd certainly like to know what Luke is involved in tonight and how Robert's involved in it, too.
Well, first Bobbie and now you. I guess it really won't do any harm in telling you this much. Luke is trying to recover some stolen art objects that were stolen from me on the docks.
That's all?
That's all. I'm afraid it's not very exciting, is it? Now, there are Luke, I would never let anything happen to him. And he's very valuable to me as well as E.L. Q. International, so you've got to stop worrying.
I know that Luke can take care of himself. I also know that he'll do anything to get the job done.
I know, that's what makes him a very good employee.
He is loyal. A little too loyal for his own good.
That is one of the traits that I absolutely adore about him.
Adore? That's sort of a strange word to use for an employee.
No, I'm not in the habit of discussing one employee with another.
But this is an exceptional case, isn't it?
Laura, why don't we just cut through all this? Now, you and Luke used to mean very much to each other at one time. You used to. And I think you're feeling a little bit left out. And I think that's what's really bothering you, isn't it? That he doesn't confide in you anymore. And you said yourself that he was loyal, very loyal. And that means keeping his mouth shut about confidential business.
I know about confidences, Alex. You and I have a few ourselves.
Laura, you haven't discussed any of Dr. Wheeler's research business with anyone, have you?
Of course not.
I'm glad.
Hello, lady.
Well, 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 Bobbie, you decided to join us.
Yes, well, actually, Joe asked me to come in because he was getting a little antsy out there. He said something about missing the action.
Well, tell him to come on in.
I don't think this is the action that he's talking about.
I don't know. I think men have this latent curiosity about what goes on in the powder room.
Well, I have to admit, I was kind of curious myself.
Well, Laura's here repairing a few damages, and it just took her a little longer than expected. And I decided to keep her company.
Because you're such good friends.
We're quite a threesome, aren't we?
Alex, hold it.
Well, no, we don't want to keep Joe waiting.
Will you answer a question, please?
Well, I'll certainly try the best I can.
I don't like the whole setup, and I'm worried about my brother. Now, what action was Joe talking about?
Luke had to make a trip down to the waterfront.
I know that, Alex. That's not enough.
Oh, come on now, you two. Luke is a grown-up man and can take care of himself.
He is my brother, and I am worried about him. Now, you tell me something, lady. Is he in over his head this time?
Of course not.
Laura?
I don't know any more than you do, Bobbie.
Now, look. Will you two just trust me?
Alex.
We hired this man because he could land on his feet. And I don't think he's going to disappoint us this time. Now, shall we go? Laura, are you coming?
In a minute.
Shall we, dear?
Where's your champion? Come here, Cassidy. I don't know what you... Get out of here! He's in town!
I don't know what you're talking about!
Where is he?
I don't know anybody.
You're gonna know me. You're not buttoned for nothing. Now, where is he?
I don't know, I tell you.
Where is he? It's your take a corner.
There he is.
Where's Cassidy?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You know where I'm talking about.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
My boy.
We came
don't
in here.
Stop walking.
Wait a second, I'll tell you.
Let's get out of here.
Five more minutes.
Come on, up we get it.
Is breakfast ready?
again.
Hi.
Hi.
I couldn't sleep.
Well, there isn't any more hot chocolate, you know.
I don't want any.
Well, what is it? You really should go back upstairs to bed. You know, tomorrow's going to be a very big day with the starting of Port Charles week.
I said I can't sleep.
Well, then why don't you try counting sheep? Or better yet, how about counting those nurses marching down the street in the parade? How about that?
It won't help.
Well, now, how do you know if you don't try? Sometimes the older ways are the better, like counting sheep to try to get to sleep.
I want to know what I can do to help my mom.
Oh, Jeremy.
I mean, she's up there crying in her room.
Well, sometimes grown-ups have to cry, too.
Should I fight with Jeff or something?
She just had a bad evening, that's all.
Well, when she came home from Mrs. Taylor's, I knew something was wrong, but you guys sent me to bed. Is she mad at me?
Of course she's not mad at you. Don't you even think that?
I know. It's just that I've never seen her like this before. Her door was shut, and I could still hear her crying.
Well, I'll go up and talk to her in a little while.
You will?
Yeah. And don't you worry. By the time morning comes, everything's going to be just fine. I promise you.
Thanks.
Now, you scoot upstairs to bed, will you?
Okay. Good night.
Good night. Rooney, come in.
I'm sorry to bother you so late.
No, that's all right. Here, let me take your coat. No more problems with that parade tomorrow, are there?
Oh, no, nothing like that.
Oh, good, because Steve has gone to bed, and I certainly wouldn't want to wake him.
Well, I wouldn't have bothered you if I hadn't seen the lights. But there's something that Steve should know about. I guess you can tell him in the morning.
Oh, all right. Well, before you tell me, how about my fixing a cup of coffee?
Oh, no, no, thanks. I won't be here long enough.
Well, what is it then?
Well, it's something that happened at the hospital. The floor nurse on four, Vera Rollins, was pretty upset. I was kind of concerned myself.
Go on, tell me.
Well, Jeff came to the hospital.
Tonight?
Yeah, it was obvious that he was all shook up about. I was checking on something with Georgia. Rick was there, too. But anyway, Jeff came in and got the keys to the records room and headed on up there.
What could he be looking for in the records room in pediatrics? And how did he get the keys from Georgia?
Well, he just grabbed them. And I don't know what he was looking for, but he found it because when he left, he had some of the records with him.
Well, where was he going?
That I don't know, but Rick went with him.
I take it he had a run-in with Vera, right?
Yes, that's what made her so upset. Rick said he'd take responsibility for the whole thing, but, well, I thought maybe I should tell Steve about it myself.
What in heaven's name could he be looking for?
You've got me, Audrey.